Alright, here we go. My skin's been doing pretty well about not breaking out, but
this morning this little guy decided to pop up.
Hello! How is everyone doing? I've had a pretty good day. I went to Gangnam earlier today and I had my first Korean lesson that I have had so far in Korea. I actually had to change tutors because the one that I was going to use had to reschedule to this weekend, and then this weekend she had to reschedule to like much later on, and so I like changed tutors, and so I ended up meeting with a different tutor than I had intended, but the lesson went well and it was really hard. We just like looked through like one of the old topic exams. The exam that you take whenever they want to test like your level of Korean for, you know, like if you want to like have permanent Korean residency. So I had my first lesson and then I went to Sucho again. I was like just, you know, checking out more around my area. I found out that there's an Auntie Anne's close to my apartment. I'm crying because I love Auntie Anne's. So today I just wanted to film like a goodbye video to my first year being in Korea. So my contract at my current school is about to end here in about like 2 weeks, 3 weeks, something like very short time to now. And you guys haven't seen most of it because I haven't been filming it, but it's been a year. I can say that. I feel like I have grown a lot as a person. And definitely as a teacher, because I like started from ground zero as a teacher, so I had nowhere to go but up, or I mean I could have gone down, but I feel like I have gone up. And just a lot has happened to me in the past year that I feel like has really like grown me. And I have to thank my school and my area where I'm living a lot for that. I have had a lot of problems with my hagwon, and that is why I am choosing to leave. I'll talk about that more maybe in like some other video after I have like actually left my hagwon. But coming now here to the end of it, you know, I've had my problems there, but at the end of this year, I can say that I have liked my time there. We've had problems, and that's why I'm choosing to leave, but I'm not leaving there with like this entirely bitter taste in my mouth, like I never want to go back there again. Like, I do still love the kids there, and like I'm really gonna miss teaching kindergarten because at my new school I'm only teaching afternoon. Side note, can you hear those cicadas down there? Like, I am like 20 floors up or 21 floors up from the ground, and these cicadas are still so loud. Korea has a huge cicada, like, I don't want to say problem because I mean there's just a lot of cicadas here. And I also learned the Korean word for cicada, which is mammy. So, but yeah, my contract ends with my current hagwon on August 16th, and I am starting training at my new hagwon like immediately, like at the same time. Like I have like no days off. Like it's like a very like immediate turnaround. I'm actually moving to Sucho the weekend before, so I am going to be commuting to my current school for like 2 days from Sucho. But you know, it's whatever, I guess. So I really wanted to film like this amazing like goodbye Annyeong video and show you like all the spots that I've hung out this year. I was gonna show you like Pyeongchang Central Park and like Bumgae and all the places that I went to go like shopping and like the club that we go to often here, like all my food spots and E-Mart and all that stuff. But then I realized I am lazy. I am so lazy. I am opting instead for this rooftop sentimental like quiet goodbye Annyeong video. I guess I could show you the view actually of like of the city here. There's like these like two towers over here which are like the biggest landmarks I guess like in this part of Pyeongchang. Also, this building here when I first came to Korea didn't exist like at all. Like I have watched it being built over the past year and it's been very interesting to watch it like come from literally the ground up. Yeah, this down here is the city I have been living in. Sorry if that sounded really annoying. That's the city I've been living in for the past year almost now. This is the roof of my office tower where I live. There is 20 floors to this building and this is the 21st floor, and coming from Texas, I am not used to seeing all these tall buildings. The tallest building I've been to in Texas was like 4 stories, 5 stories, like not tall at all. That's probably not true. I've probably been in taller buildings, but I'm not used to seeing tall buildings outside of like Dallas. Coming from Waco, like when I went to Baylor, and also living in Anna and like all various areas of North Texas growing up all my life, I'm not used to seeing one, so many buildings, and two, so many tall buildings. Like everything in Texas is so spread out in like one story and you have to have a car to go anywhere. And now in Korea, everything I do is just when I'm walking the streets, I just have to go like this to like see where everything is. One thing that I love about Korea is that everything is so close together and everything that I need is like within a 5 to 10 minute walk from my apartment. And also public transit here is awesome. I love the subway and the bus and like taxis can take me everywhere. Like I'm not used to that at all. Also, just another random side note, I love that like public transportation here is so safe. Like the subway is so safe because I like see subways in like other countries. Like recently I've been like on this kick of watching videos of North Korea, which if you're from America, I have been advised, do not go there, like, anytime soon. Because of the political climate, there is, like, no relationship, like, whatsoever between the two, and it just, if you go, they could, like, keep you as, like, poker chips to, like, be like, look, US, we've got your people, like, do what we say, or we're gonna nuke you. So that's a little bit concerning. So as much as I would love to go see North Korea, I'm not planning on going anytime soon. So that's gonna be a trip that will come later in my Korea life, I guess. Side note, I also just wanna show you, this mountain looks so pretty. Look at that mountain over there. Like, I'm not used to seeing mountains. This is so cool. I love where, there you are. That's so pretty. I love it. I love to come up to this rooftop a lot to just, like, escape life whenever, like, work gets too crazy or I'm just overwhelmed with the, like, not any stresses that I have, but I tell myself that I, like, I'm overwhelmed sometimes emotionally. So I come up here and I just like to, like, you know, chill out on these benches or come hang out over here, like, look at the view of, you know, just my city. I really am going to miss living here because I do love my area. It's very convenient. Like, everything I need is so close to me. The station is like a 5-minute walk away. E-Mart is connected to the station and is like 3 minutes away. Every food place I need is really close. My school is like, I do cab to school every day, which is kind of annoying, but like, it's not like terribly far. And I could walk if I wanted to. I'm just lazy AF and I don't like being sweaty whenever I go to work. So my new area in Socho, it is convenient that it's in Seoul, so it's closer to things, but I don't know if I'm gonna have other things like immediately convenient to me like I do here. But you know, the biggest thing about my new school and the kind of the trade-off I had to make about choosing my new school over my current one, at my current one I'm making quite a bit of money and I just have to work long hours to compensate for that. I work 11 to 12 hour days 5 days a week, but I'm being compensated for that. Like, I do make a lot of money. On the other hand, my new school that I am going to is only 4 days a week, and it's only in the afternoon, so I'm only gonna be working like maybe 8 hours a day. So it's like 32 hours less pay versus like, you know, 55 to 60 hours, but like a lot more pay. And so it's just like, basically I had to decide whether money or happiness was more important to me, and I guess I'm just choosing happiness. So I'm hoping that this is the right decision. My family and like all my friends have told me that this is the right decision and they agree with what I'm choosing to do. So I'm really just like, I'm trying to establish a good life for myself, because this year I have been so like overwhelmed with like how crazy my job is. It really hasn't been until like the past few months that I felt comfortable even doing anything with my time. Like every day I just go to work and then I eat dinner and I come home and sleep, and then on the weekends I sleep, and then I rarely like go out and do anything because I'm just so exhausted. And it really hasn't been really until the summer now that I'm close to the end of my contract where I finally feel comfortable, you know, like filming vlogs again like I have been, and then like doing stuff on the weekends, like I went to the Britney concert and like doing stuff like that, you know. I probably could make it like a second year at my current school, but at the end of the day I just don't want to. Like, I could, but I don't want to. And I think that in the end is what is pushing me towards like this decision that I'm making to go to my new school. So hoping it's the right decision. Only time will tell. We'll see what it's like after I get there. You know, if I decide that I don't like it, at least I only have to be there like 32 hours a week, and then I don't have to be there on Fridays except for like once a month. So I have much less time I have to be there if I decide I don't like it. Whereas now I don't like my school and I'm trapped there like 60 hours a week in prison and I can't leave ever. So yeah, I really don't know what else to say or, you know, do. I guess I can show you more of Pyeongchang. If we look over there, let's see if I, there we go. There we go. Over here is Pyeongchang Central Park. I have spent many a night walking through there. I have to walk through there and then like down that way to get to my Hagwon. Anyang Finance Center is here. This building that I have seen being built the past year. The one I call the Twin Towers are here. I think these are actually like called the Acro Towers, the Acro Building or something like that. Beautiful mountains. Oh my god, so beautiful. I want to go mountain climbing. I haven't done that yet in Korea, so hopefully I'll do that. Got a cute view down of the street. I can't zoom in any farther because my camera won't, but just people doing their daily lives. I have no idea that I'm filming them right now. There's down the other way, and now I'm getting like really worried that I'm gonna drop my camera and I'm getting nauseous, so I'm gonna stop doing this now. Also, if we run over, I want to show you the other side view too. There's another side. Da-da-da. Is there anyone over here to judge me? No. Brilliant. So here's the other pagoda thing, and then here's the view from the other side of Anyang with you. Also, I'm still bitter that like these other buildings next to me have better rooftop views than we do. Like, ours is pretty trash compared to these. Okay, back to the spot. These cicadas are getting loud again, and it's really annoying. But I guess that's it. I'm going to Japan in less than 2 days, and I still have a lot to figure out. Like, one, I don't know how I'm getting to the airport yet. You'll hear all about that whenever I make my travel vlog for Japan, I'm sure. But I'm going on vacation this week, and then next weekend I am moving, and then the week after that I am starting my new job. So it's just gonna be like, August is like a crazy month for me. So hopefully uploading will keep happening, because I'm like, I love that I'm like back in this routine, you know, doing the thing, only the thing that I've known to do with my like spare time since 2007, which is make YouTube videos for the internet. So hopefully that will keep happening as frequently as I would like. But I think for now I'm gonna go, I'm gonna edit this video, and start packing for Japan. I'm so excited. I haven't been on vacation since December when I went to Thailand. I'm like so ready. I am so ready to like not be at work for 3 days. Okay, see you next time. Bye.